maths. You know that we are learning the chapter division. Okay, and till now we have learned the division by one digit number and division by two digit number. Division of five and six digit numbers by one digit number and two digit number. In that we have learned the division with remainder and without remainder. In some examples we found remainder zero means without remainder, and in some examples we found remainder other than zero, that is 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, that is with remainder. So now see, in today's lecture we are going to learn the next concept in this chapter. The concept is division by 10, 100 or 1000. If you remember, same concept we have learned in the previous chapter, multiplication. If you remember, multiplication by 10, 100 or 1000. Okay, so how we had done that, multiplication, we use shortcut trick, that is trick. Okay, so same we have to do here also. While performing division by 10, 100 or 1000, we have to go by shortcut. We don't have to divide by long method. We have to go by shortcut. So how to divide using that shortcut, we will learn that. Before that, we will learn reason behind that. Means if we use the shortcut trick, why that trick is applicable here, that we learn first. We will take one example here. Suppose 46 divided by 10. If we want to divide 46 divided by 10. So see here, if you want to divide 46, when we divide 46 by 10, what will happen? See, you know 10 table. So 46 is not there in table of 10, then smaller number in table of 10 is 40. So 10, 4 is 40. 6 minus 0, 6. 4 minus 0, 4. Or 4 minus 4, 0. Okay. We will take another example. 352 divided by 10. Okay. So let's divide here 352 by 10 in our traditional method, long division method. See. 10, 3 is 30. Correct. 5 minus 0, 5. 3 minus 3, 0. 2 will come down, became 52. 52 is not there in table of 10. There is a smaller number than 52. In table of 10 is 50. So 10, 5 is 50. Correct? So 2 minus 0, 2. 5 minus 0, 5 minus 5 is 0. So here, quotient is 35. Remainder is 2. Here, quotient is 4. Remainder is 6. One more example we will take. 1265 divided by 10. Okay, now see. 1265 divided by 10. See now, first we divide to 12, right? So 12 is not there in table of 10, so smaller number than 12 in table of 10 is 10 itself. So 10 ones are 10. Okay, 2 minus 0 is 2, 1 minus 1 is 0. 6 will come down, we get 26. 10 2's are 20. 26 is not there in table of 10. So 10 2's are 20. Okay. 6 minus 0, 6. 2 minus 2, 0. 5 will come down. Became 65. 65 is not divisible by 10. The smaller number than 65 is 60, which is divisible by 10. 10 6's are 60. I am taking it fast because it's very easy. Yeah, you know that. So here, see, quotient is 126. Remainder is 5. Quotient is, when we divided 46 divided by 10, at that time quotient is 4 and remainder is 6. Correct. When we divided 352 by 10, what is quotient? 35 and remainder 2. When we divide it 1265 by 10, at that time what is quotient? 126 and remainder 5. Observe this. Which pattern you get here? Which pattern do you observe here in these three examples? God pattern? See the quotient. Observe the quotient and remainder. Observe this example. Also observe quotient and remainder. Initially you will get the pattern in the answers. Got? See here. If you see here in the first example, 46 divided by 10, quotient is 4. Quotient is 4 means and remainder is 6. Remainder 6 means this last digit. And this is quotient. 4 is quotient, right? In the second example, 352 divided by 10. At that time, what is remainder? 2. Again, last digit is remainder. And 35 is quotient means rest part of the number is quotient 35. 1265 divided by 10. At that time, what is remainder? 5 means again last digit is remainder. And 126 is quotient. Rest part of the number is quotient. This is the shortcut. This is the pattern which we call trick. Okay, shortcut. So you understood, if when we divide any number by 10, when we divide any number by 10, the last digit becomes remainder. The last digit becomes remainder and rest part of the number becomes quotient. Understood? See all this 46, 352, 1265. The last digit is remainder 6, remainder 2, remainder 5. Last digit is remainder. Okay? And rest part of the number, here only one rest part means only one digit is there, 4. So 4 become quotient. The rest part, number formed by rest part, remaining part is 35. So 35 is the quotient. Here number formed by remaining digits, that is 126. So 126 is the quotient. Got it? So this is the shortcut. Now again, why only last digit? That also, there is also logic behind it. See, in 10 there is 1 0, only 1 0 is there. In 10, there is only 1 0. So, only last one digit is the remainder. And rest part of the number is quotient. Then instead of 10, there if there is 100, what will happen? See, for example, 552 divided by 100, then what will be quotient? What will be remainder? Again, 3297 divided by 100, then what will be quotient? What will be remainder? 57,865 divided by 100, then what will be quotient and what will be remainder? Can you guess? Now you know this shortcut. Can you guess here? What will be quotient and what will be remainder? Here when there was division by 10, there is only 1 0 in 10. So last one digit was remainder. And rest part of the number was quotient. Here in 100, when we divide by 100, in 100 there are 2 zeros. So is there any relation of that 2 zeros with the remainder? Of course, yes. See, in 100 there are 2 zeros. If we divide this number by 100, the number, the last 2 digits will become remainder. 52 will become remainder. And rest part of the number will become quotient. 5 will become quotient. Here 97 will become remainder and 32 will be quotient. 65 will become remainder, number from my last digit, and rest part will become 578 will become quotient. Now why this is so, that also you can check by doing division in this way. Divide this by 100. You know table of 100, 100 ones are 100, 100 twos are 200, 100 threes are 300, 400, 500, 600 and so on. So if you want to verify, if you want to check, you can do the division in this way and you can check, you will get same number formed by last two digit is a remainder and rest part of the number is quotient. Same for 1000. What will be remainder? I'll take examples for 1000. 5792 divided by 1000. 67,878 divided by 1,000, 5,35,767 divided by 1,000. So in these examples, what would be quotient and remainder? What will be remainder? What will be quotient? Can you tell me using same logic? Can you tell me remainder and quotient there? Or can you guess? You can't tell me now, but can you guess? You can guess it. Wow. See, in 1000 there are 3 zeros. So number formed by last 3 digits in will be the remainder. Number formed by last 3 digits will be the remainder, and rest part of the number is quotient. So quotient is 5. Number formed by last 3 digits will be the remainder. Quotient is 67. Number formed by last 3 digits is remainder. 535 is the quotient and 767 is the remainder. Understood? This is the shortcut, and this is the reason behind the shortcut. If you divide that number by 1000, you can make table of 1000. 1000 ones are 1000, 1000 twos are 2000, 3000, 4000. Same way, like I told you the table of 100. Okay. So if you divide 5792 by 1000, you will get quotient 5 and remainder 792. Okay? Remainder, keep it in mind, remainder is always less than the divisor. Means remainder is always less than divisor. Okay? That is one of the points you have to keep it in mind. So this is the idea behind the shortcut. When we are going to divide it, and remember once again, when there is division by 10, 100, 1000, you have to go by the shortcut only. This is the reason behind to take this concept separately. That you must know the shortcut. You should divide by shortcut, not by this wrong method. Okay? So if you are dividing here in the paper, if example is given, and if you are dividing by wrong method, I am going to give it wrong. Though your answer is correct, I am going to give it wrong, because that is not the purpose of this concept. You must go by shortcut. Now see here, practice 5.3, which is based on this. We are going to solve it. Complete the table. Here some examples are given, as I gave you there, and quotient and remainder we have to write. Remember, if there is division by 10, underline last one digit, because in 10 there is 10. If there is division by 100, in 100 there are 2 zeros, so underline two, the last 2 digits, that will be your remainder. If there is division by 1000, underline last 3 digits, that will be your remainder. Okay. 9600 divided by 10. Okay, divided by 10 is there, so which last one digit you have to underline, and rest part of the number will be your quotient. So this last one digit will be remainder, and 960 will be your quotient. Okay. Then 3688 divided by 100. Now in 100 there are 2 zeros, so underline last 2 digits, that will be your remainder, and rest part will be your quotient. So 88 is the remainder, 36 is the quotient. Understood? It's easy, you can do it now. Divide by 40,000, divide by 1000. So in 1000 there are 3 zeros, so 1, 2, 3. Number formed by last 3 digits is your remainder. That is 0, 0, 0 means 0 only. And quotient is 40. Okay, then 3000 divided by 10. Again there is 1 zero, so underline last 1 digit. Okay, so 300 is your quotient and 0 is the remainder. Then again there is division by 10, underline last digit. 49,000 is the quotient and 0 is remainder. 7815 divided by 10, 10, division by 10, so last 1 digit will be your remainder, and quotient is 781. Okay, 10,900 divided by 100. Two zeros are there in 100. Underline last two digits. 109 will be your quotient and 100 will be, sorry, 0 will be your remainder. 0, 0 means 0. Same again. Divide by 100. So underline last two digits. 506 is your quotient and 0 is your remainder. Okay? So in this way we have to go by shortcut. It's very easy. Solve the remaining examples in this first question. There are total 14 examples. 8 we have solved here. Rest of the examples we have to solve as a homework today itself. Okay? So now write this. After that, we will see the question number 2 in this practice 5.3. See the second question. Find quotient for each of the following. Now, what is different in this? This is the concept, that is division by 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, and so on till 90s. Means what the divisors which are there, 20, 40, 50, 90, means they are multiples of 10. They are multiples of 10. Then what is different in this? Why it is given different? Something is there. Something is different there, right? What is the different or is there any shortcut? Let's see here. Here also see. Why doing this division? We have learned division of by two digit number. Okay, then something is different there. What is the difference there? See. If you see this dividend and the divisor, last digit of both of these number is 0. Correct? Here also, last digit is 0. In the divisor also, last digit is 0. Here also, last digit is 0. And in the divisor also, last digit is 0. Right? So, what to do with that 0? We can, if the last digit of dividend and divisor is 0, last one digit or last two digits of both the divisor and dividend are 0, then we can cut that. We can directly cut that. See, here also last digit is 0, here also last digit is 0. So this 0 we can cut with this 0. Now instead of 20, it remains 2. There remain 2. Now we can divide it easily, right? So when we cut this 0, the division becomes easy. Instead of dividing by 20, if we cut this 0, this 0 in the dividend, then division becomes easy, right? So now division is 3,284 divided by 2, not 20. What changes we have done? What we have reduced? We cut last 0 from both the dividend and divisor. Okay, so we got this number now 3. It was 32,840 divided by 20. Then we cut this 0 and we got the number 3,284 divided by 2. It is same as this. Okay, so let's divide now by 2. 3 divided, first we divide to 3 because 3 is greater than 2, so we can divide it. 2 ones are 2. 3 is not there in table of 2, so a smaller number than 3 in table of 2 is 2 itself. So 3 minus 2 is 1. Let's bring next digit down. 2 came down, became 12. Is there 12 in table of 2? Yes. 2 6 are 12. So 2 6 are 12. 2 minus 2 0, 1 minus 1 0. Next digit will come down. 0 0 8 means 8 only. Divide 8 by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. Okay? So 2 4s are 8. 8 minus 8, 0. 4 will come down. 0 4 means 4 only, and 4 is there in the table of 2. 2 2s are 4. 4 minus 4, 0. Okay? So the quotient is 1642 and remainder is 0. Understood? So what happens due to as we have cut these zeros, last zeros in dividend and divisor, the division has become easy. Okay. Next, 13,280 divided by 40. 13,280 divided by 40. If you directly divide 13,280 by 40, or here we take, if you directly divide 32,840 by 20, then also you get same question. Okay? But you need to say table of 20. So instead of that, if you cut last zeros, this zero with the zero, the last zero in the divisor, then what happens? Division becomes easy, you have to say table of 2. So it's become easy, okay? Here also same we are going to do. This last zero in the dividend, remember zero should be at the end. If you are thinking that zero is there, this way zero is in the middle somewhere, you cannot cut this zero with this zero, okay? Remember zero must be at the end only. Then only we can cut that zero. So now your number is 1328 divided by 4. Let's divide it. 13 is not there in table of 4, but smaller number than 13 is 12. 4 3s are 12. 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. 2 will come down, became 12 again. 4 3s are 12. 2 minus 2 0, 1 minus 1 0. 8 will come down. 0 0 8 means 8 only. 4 2s are 8. Okay, quotient is 332, remainder is 0. Next, 13,750 divided by 50. Cut last two zeros. Don't cut this 5 with this 5, no. Only zeros can be cut, okay? 1375 divided by 5. Divide 13 by 5, 13 is not there in table of 5. The smaller number than 13 in table of 5 is 10, right? 5 2s are 10. 3 minus 0, 3. 1 minus 1, 0. 7 came down. 37 is again not there in table of 5. Then which number is this? Smaller than 37, which is in table of 5? 5 7s are 35. 5 7s are 35. Table should be perfect, then you can do this division within less time. Okay, 7 minus 5 is 2, 3 minus 3 is 0. 5 came down. When you see the number here, immediately you should remember, yes, this number is not there in table of divisor. And which is the smaller number than this number? Immediately you should remember. Okay, 25, it is there in table of 5. 5 5s are 25. So quotient is 275 and remainder is 0. Next, this is example number E. Example number D is there is division by 10. Okay, so you can do that using the shortcut. See here also last zeros will be cut with the last zero in the divisor. The number became 22,158 divided by 9. Let's first we divide to 22 directly, okay? So 9 on the 9, 9 2 is 18. Yes, 18 is the smaller number. 22 minus 18. 2 minus 8, not possible. 2 will become 12. 1 will remain 0. 2 will remain 1. 12 minus 8 is 4. 1 minus 1, 0. This one will come down. Became 41. Now again, 41 is not there in table of 9. Then smaller number than 41 in table of 9 is? 9 4s are 36. Because 9 5s are 45. 45 is greater than 41. So we cannot take that. 1 minus 6 again, not possible. From this 4, take one borrowed here. But this one right up. 4 will become 3. 11 minus 6, 5. 3 minus 3 is 0. 5 will come down. Again, 9 5s are 45. 9, 6 are 54. See, 54. Here there is 55, that means 54 is smaller number. 9, 6 are 54.
5 minus 4, 1. 5 minus 5, 0. Last digit will come down to 8. 8 is there in table of 9, right? 9, 2 is 8. Sorry, 18 is there in table of 9. So here quotient is 2462 and remainder is 0. So in this way we have to solve the division where we have to divide by the multiples of 10, that is 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay? If last digit in both the dividend and divisor is 0, you can cut that 0. For example, I am giving. Here there are two zeros and there is division by 100. So here also there are last two zeros and here also last two zeros are there. This zero will cut for this zero, this zero will cut for this zero. Okay? Or here there is one zero, here there are two zeros. What will happen? Only last zero will cut for this zero. Here instead of 100 there will remain 10. Okay? So this, but you don't have example like this. It will be next class. So now write down these examples you have to write in the notebook. Understood? The first question which we have seen, that you have to write in the textbook. There is space in the textbook. So I hope you have understood this. If you have any doubt in this, you are free to ask. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.